Welcome back, everybody. Matt the Matt here. Hope you are doing well. And today is the 20th anniversary of Spider-Man 2, the sequel to the 2002 Spider-Man film, directed by Sam Raimi, starring Tobey Maguire, Kirsten Dunst, James Franco, Rosemary Harris. And with the sequel, we're introduced to Alfred Molina as Dr. Octavius. Doc Ock, as J. Jonah Jameson coins the phrase. This is my favorite Spider-Man movie in film. As a lot of people know, Spider-Man is my second favorite comic book character outside of Batman. I've always been a huge fan of Spider-Man. I had the original Spider-Man movie poster hanging in my room growing up after the 2002 movie came out. Spider-Man 2 is an excellent, not only sequel to the original, as a comic book movie, one of the best comic book films, superhero films, and I love that first Sam Raimi Spider-Man. It was a great origin film. So it was always very much like, is the sequel going to be better than the original? And yes, it is. Even just starting the movie off with the opening credits, with the Alex Ross paintings, kind of recapping what happened in the original film, was amazing, with the Danny Elfman Spider-Man theme score in the background. Perfect. It didn't go into every plot detail, but it got the highlight moments of the original. I love the first 15 minutes of this movie. It literally shows you the life of Peter Parker, who also has a duality of Spider-Man, between trying to get to class and being late to class, between trying to hold down a job, two jobs in a way, one at the pizza place, and then one working with J. Jonah Jameson, the Daily Bugle, not able, he's late to pizza, late, Parker, always late, pizza time, and then, you know, J. Jonah, Parker, you're late, Parker, you're fired. Alright, you're not fired. And then, you know, forgetting that it's his actual birthday, you know. Then we see him helping those little kids that were about to cross the road and almost get run over. Like I said, he forgets his own birthday and goes home. And there's MJ and Harry and Aunt May. And they're like, surprise! And he's like, what? It's your birthday. Oh. You forgot about your birthday? And then obviously still wanting MJ, and Harry's still mad about Spider-Man. Still taking pictures of Spider-Man. How's the bug these days? If you knew, would you tell me? And then we got him going to his apartment. And his apartment, his tenant, rent, one of the greatest lines in movie history, rent, where's my money? I'm sorry, Mr. Dinkovich, sorry, if sorry was cookies, my daughter would be fat, the eyes of a rodent, and the ears of a snake. one of the best characters in a comic book movie. That's the type of humor that Sam Raimi brings to his Spider-Man movies. Or the whole scene when Peter stops being Spider-Man, and he's out in public, and he's wearing the white shirt with the glasses back on, and the song Raindrops Are Falling on My Head. A very odd song, but almost it worked perfectly in the movie, you know. Then you got the whole humor with my back. I still have that. you know, that may be why I am Spider-Man. My back, my back. You know, you got that, or the elevator scene. Yeah, it rides up in the crutch. You have so many great moments. But then you got some horror elements with the whole hospital scene with Doc Ock. Let's not talk about Alfred Molina, who gives a great performance as Dr. Octavius. That whole, I mean, it's almost 30 minutes into the movie before he finally gets the tentacles. That whole first part is character-driven. You know, meeting Doc Ock, then with his wife, and sitting at the table talking about poetry. Day by day, I gazed upon her. Day by... Can I get you a drink? I don't need a drink. And then, like, the Doc Ock with the... And the action with the bank robbing scene. Or the infamous train sequence. One of the best action sequences in any comic book movie. The way Sam Raimi films Spider-Man flying through the city, swinging through the city, it hasn't been matched in either the Amazing Spider-Man movies or the Tom Holland Spider-Man movies. I said the humor, J. Jonah Jameson, a hero, a menace. Parker, you're fired. Can I get a raise? What are you, for real? Planetarium, 8 o'clock. The amazing soundtrack. The soundtrack to this movie is, I'm not talking about the score by Danny Elfman with the Doc Ock theme and the Spider-Man theme. I'm talking about the actual soundtrack. The soundtrack that I bought on CD back in 2004. And listened to that entire summer on my way to Florida for vacation. Or once I got my car 2 years later, I played that CD in my car. You had Ordinary, great song. Or Vindicated, my Dashboard Confessions. Or Jet, Hold On, my Jet. It's a great soundtrack that I would listen to all the time. I like how this is character driven. Like I said, the first 15 minutes of this movie is showing the life of Peter Parker. You know, what it's like to be Spider-Man. It's not fun. It's not really not enjoyable. You're not helping anyone really at the end of the day. You're not going to class. You're not getting to work on time. You're not there for your friends. You're trying to get the girl, but she doesn't know you're Spider-Man. So she thinks you're blowing her off all the time. And then, like, then you got the whole introduction of Doc Ock that is over 30 minutes in the movie until he becomes Doc Ock. And then, like, then the train sequence. Then even after him, when he's lying down with the mask off, and, you know, he sits up. We won't tell anybody. Even a lot of the transitions are great. From Doc Ock's mask, from his sunglasses, and then it zooms out into the city. Or when the Spider-Man emblem goes in into Harry Osborn's apartment. I mean, a lot of great transitions in this movie. And I like how it focuses. I like that they only decided to have one villain in the sequel. Most sequels will at least have two villains. Second movie? Two villains! Yeah! No, not on this movie. Like, we're only going to have one villain. I like that. It focuses only on one villain. Yes, you see the downward spiral of Harry Osborn throughout the movie, which was great, but they still only focused on one main villain. And really, Doc Ock wasn't like this horrible person. He just wanted the power of the sun. in the palm of my hand. Oh yes, Parker, brilliant but lazy. That's what my family says all the time. He's brilliant, he's really smart, but he's fucking lazy. And then it deals with that. And it also has three characters. I'm gonna do a podcast down the road of the three. It's gonna be called The Three in movies. But you're focusing on three different characters in their arc. Peter, MJ, Harry. And, you know, one of them is, you know, trying to figure out how to be Spider-Man. And you all, and me there for MJ, me there for Harry, me there for Aunt May. You know, go to work for J. Jonah Jameson. You know, pizza time for pizza. Go to class, you know, and meet Spider-Man at the same time. You know, MJ finally becomes an actress, but she's also dating this guy who went on to be in the Vampire Diaries, Michelson. One of the Michelsons, the brother. And then you have Harry going down this spiral. You know, at the beginning he's still mad about Spider-Man. He wants to get Spider-Man, but he thinks with Doc Ock he's gonna bring his company, the Oscorp, back to you know, the top. And then when that goes south, he really goes down a spiral. Even to the point that when you end this movie, they end this movie on MJ. The movie ends on MJ. And she doesn't have a happy look on her face. She has this is a look that you go, oh. Oh. Did I make the right choice? The guy I proclaim my love to just goes off and saves the day. Here I am in a wedding dress. Is this gonna be the future? Yes. What did I do? What have I done? Did I make the right choice? She doesn't have a happy face on her face. Say that 10 times fast. She doesn't have a happy face on her face. He has this look of, oh no. Very interesting to end a movie on that note. But very powerful, and once again, without any dialogue, you know exactly what she's thinking in that moment. But then the apartment neighbors, great. The action, great. I have two minor problems with this movie. Number one, the scene in the second act, when Peter is still, and I love when he finally decides not to be Spider-Man. He's able to go and live a normal life. I even love the scenes where the cops are running down the road to go save someone. And he's like eating that hot dog, like, not today. Or when he sees the guy getting beat up in the alleyway. Not my problem. Kind of like his attitude in the first Spider-Man. The ad said 3,000. Yeah. And that's not my problem. Not my problem. You know, it kind of shows that, like, you as a viewer, like, oh, come on, buddy. You're Spider-Man. Help that guy. No, no. But anyway, getting back to what I was saying. Like, my minor name is the fire sequence. When he's normal Peter, not Spider-Man anymore, and he runs into the building and saves the little girl from the fire, but someone else dies anyway. I know what they're trying to do, like, if you were Spider-Man, you would have had the spider sense, to know there's another person in this building, and you would have saved them. But since you're not Spider-Man, you didn't have the spider sense. But I feel like since we had a fire sequence scene, in the first one with the goblin, I wish they did what they did in the second one, with the little girl trapped, but maybe not in a fire, maybe in something else. But that's just me. That's just me. Also, this is a movie that is only 2 minutes. 2 minutes? Because of 2 minutes, you're not going to open the door because of 2 minutes. 2 minutes longer than the original, too. But for some reason, ever since when I saw this in the movie theater at the old AMC in Alpharetta, in the stadium seating, in on July 1st, 2004, this movie, for only being 2 hours, even if just 2 hours before the credits begin, at only 2 hours, this movie's pacing is awful. I love this movie. Great character development, character arts, great action, great everything. But for some reason, this movie feels like it's 2.5 hours, or 3 hours long. I don't know why. The pacing is slow. Like I said, the first one moves at a great pace, and is only 2 minutes shorter than this movie. But somehow, this movie feels like it's sometimes 2.5 to 3 hours. Don't know why. But that's about it. I mean, this is a great sequel. It's a great comic book movie. It's a great Spider-Man movie, the best Spider-Man movie. It's a great action movie. Great action sequences. Great character-driven story. So, are you a fan of Spider-Man 2, directed by Sam Raimi? Is this one of your favorite Spider-Man movies? Can you believe it's already 20 years old? Oh boy. Let me know in the comments below. Hit the like button, hit the subscribe button, leave a comment. Tell me, what's your Spider-Sense feeling today?